Hello. Have you filled the form?
Yes.
Okay, today we are going to discuss a project which is employee management system using JDBC.
What did I write in the employee ID?
Yeah, if you don't have employee ID, you can simply mention NA. If you have it, you can fill it. So today we are going to discuss a project that is employee management system. So let me open our project. So I'm creating new class. As it is employee management system, so I'm taking it as EMS. So before that, we should create the table for that. So let me open my function. We are using JDBC. So till now we have tables three. One is accounts, one is image, and one is student. So now we are creating employees. Create table. ID, which is int we can take, and is a primary key. Name, not null. Role, it's also not null. Salary, we'll take decimal. It is also not null. So now we have created table, we can see. So if we describe our table, we can see. So we have four fields. One is ID, which is int type and primary key. Name, which is varchar like string, and it won't allow null values. And one is role, which is also string, and it won't allow null. And one is float, salary, which is decimal. In Java, it will be like float, and it won't allow null values. So now we have successfully created the table. And let us go to Eclipse. So for connection and all this. So here we have taken three variables, URL, username, password, and register the driver and open the connection also. Should give the catch. So it will be SQL exception. Connection failed. So now we'll be giving the options for the user, like when we are running the code, we should see the operations which we can do. So for that, first we'll print. Employee management system. So after this, we'll simply give the options, whatever we wanted to perform. So here one will be show employees. It will give all the employees. And one will be add employee. And next, update employee. Next, show employee. Using ID. And next, show employees will give all the employees, and add employee should use to add the employee. Update will be update. And show employee using ID will be giving only one employee with the ID. And fifth one will be delete employee. And then sixth option will be exit. So next, we'll be asking the user for enter your choice. So the user giving the choice, we should take the choice. That's why we are using in ch to store the user choice. So we'll be reading with the help of scanner. So sc dot extend. So now according to the choice, we'll be performing the operation. So for that, we should use switch. We cannot use if like that, as it is multiple options. So we should use switch. And I'm passing the choice to the switch. And here. Case one will be showing employees. One second. Is my screen visible?
No.
Everything is
showing. Now it is visible, right? Yeah, fine. So case one will be showing employees. So if it is the option, I should go for a method. So that will be creating in below. So for now, I am taking the method as show employees. Calling that method to show the employees. So now we should give the definition for this method. So after that, we should use break. Because it should not go for other cases, that's why we should use break. So now case 2 will be insert employee. So I will tell you what are the parameters we should pass to the methods also. Case 3 will be update employee. In case 4 will be, it is using ID, right? So get employee by ID. In case 5 will be delete employee. Case 6 will be what is it? Exit, right? 61. So, exit will simply go using system.exit. So it will completely terminate the program. So before that, we'll simply print employee management system. Exiting. And one more case there, that would be default. So default, what happens if you are giving any other option instead of 1 2 3 4 5 6, it should tell the user invalid choice. Try again. And so if you are giving any 789, it should go to the switch like this line. So enter your choice again. So how it will go? Just simply we'll add a loop here that will be like what can you say, continuing until it goes for false, like it will be running unlimited time. So I'm using simply true and giving it. So after that, let me put all this code into the loop. So that's how when we are giving a false like 789 out of our options, that time it will again go to the loop. So this is how our code looks like now. Okay, where is end of while? One second. Okay, fine. So now we should give the definition for this method. So when we wanted to show employees, we need the connection, this object. So we should pass this and nothing much. After that, inserting also, we need connection. The values will take inside method only. For everything we need connection. So we'll see if we need anything more. So till now we have completed the methods. And now how the methods will be given. So as it is explained now, Eclipse, I can just simply take the suggestion and create method. So we can see the method is created here. So private static void show employees connection con. So that's how we can create for all the methods. See, we have 6 methods. We have all the 6 methods. Update employee, get employee, when ID, delete employee, all the 6 methods. So now we should write code for these methods. So before that, just let us execute this and we'll see what is coming in the output. After that, we'll simply give the definition for methods. See, we are getting employee management system and options and the choice to enter. So I'm choosing one. So if there is no functionality is given, that's why it is again coming. So now we'll give the definition for method. So delete will be, first we'll take the query. Delete from employees where ID equals to, we should use prepare statement, so that's why I'm using question. So now we should write object prepare statement P equals to con dot prepare statement and we should pass this query. Thank you. So it will be like sometimes it also will throw the query, like SQL query, SQL exception. That's why we should have the try catch. Instead, we can simply use throws here also. That's also fine. So that will do for another method. So now it's fine, and we should add the ID. So how the ID will be taken? I'm declaring a variable int ID, and I'm giving a line. Please enter ID of employee. So which employee we wanted to delete, that ID we should give. So after that will be read like taken like using scanner. So we see dot next int. So here scanner we have given inside main method. So it's outside main, that's why it is not taking, it is showing error. For that we simply just pass the scanner here. So for reading, like show employees, scanner is not required, it will give all the employees, but remaining all things it needs scan. So as we have added new parameter, it is showing error. So that is cleared using this parameter here. Scanner is, so it should now, this should be added to all other methods also. Delete employee, get employee by ID, update employee also, insert employee also, show employees, not needed. So now here I'm using next. So now we have the ID. How will give this ID to prepare statement? So that will be done. Anyone can tell, as we are discussing so many things with JDBC, how we can pass this? You are saying every day, understood, but you are not replying now.
Does it take a variable inside the
field? Okay. We should use the object to prepare statement, and we should use set as the column name is ID and its type is integer. So that's why we should use here set int. So we can see suggestions also, and it will take two parameters. One is index value of ID in the query. So here we have only one parameter, so that's index value will be 1, and the other value is the ID which we wanted to delete. So for now I'm taking 10. It is not at all added to table, that will add in coming expression. So for now I'm taking 10. Sorry, it is not 10, it is ID, as I have scanned here now. So I can pass ID here. So after this, now the parameter is assigned to this ID here. So now we should execute query. So how it will be? First we should take rows. It will show rows affected or not. And using this prepare statement object, we should use execute update. So this is how the query will be executed. And now we check if the operation is performed or not. If rows greater than 0, we simply say ID successfully deleted. So ID is the ID which we wanted to delete. So if it is not successfully done, we have the else block. Here we'll say deletion fail. So here, if you are interested, you can also do some more work. If you are asking one ID to be deleted, so this ID should be there in the table now. So you can give one more condition and check whether the ID is available inside the table or not. If it is not available, that time you can simply display the user is not available on the table. That is, you can try yourself. I'm giving the idea to do that. And now coming to get employee by ID. So for this, first we need a query. That is select star from employees where ID equals to. So here also we'll take the ID like this, and we set the ID to the ID to the query. So similarly, we can copy paste. We just take the ID from the user. Please enter ID of the employee, and we just scan the ID. Let me create a field also. So that's how when we have created object to prepare statement is showing two suggestions, that is surrounded with try catch or and throws. Now we are using and throws. So if we adding throws here, no need to use try catch. This is you have completed in exception handling. So after this, simply do. So till now it was like operation, so it is giving rows updated, like rows affected, but it is now selected na? So how will take it? We should use result set to take the values. Result set or equals to, what should we do here? Can anyone tell? Should use p dot execute query. And we should import result set. So after that, we should traverse from result set. So I'm using while loop. While loop on dot next till it have the next. We should take all the values, like it will be giving four values now, which are these four: ID, name, role, salary. So we should assign all these to local variables. That should be int ID. I cannot use again, so I am taking int result ID, one variable, and I can just simply assign here only using object to the result set on dot get int which is ID from the table. And similarly in result name equals to on dot get string which is name from the table. What happened? Sorry, so I have taken in my string. And now what are the other two? One is role and one is salary. So I'm taking string role on dot get string which is role, and one is salary, right? Float result salary equals to get float. Do we have or dot get so we can see get float, and that is sal. Now we have assigned all these values to the local variables, and now time to print them. So we'll simply give employee details ID plus result ID. Next line, here we use employee ID. That will be good. here. Employee. Name. Plus result name. In the next line, employee role plus result role. So simply, I have taken role, so I'm resuming on the role. And next, employee salary. I'm taking plus result salary. So it is only one employee, that's fine. So this is how we'll get details of one employee. And next thing we'll do is insertion. So if we do this, we can perform insertion from this program. So let me complete insertion. Sorry, it's insert into employees. The parameters are ID, name, role and salary. Values will be 4 question marks as it is prepared statement. So now the query is completed. So we should have these all things. So I'm just created the prepare statement. So now we should read 4 values. So I'm taking int id, string name comma role, float sal, and I should read all this. So enter employee id. ID equals to s dot next int. Similarly, all the other 4. Enter employee name. Name equals to s dot next. If we wanted to take first name, last name both, we should use next line. If we have any space in the string we are reading, we should use next line. If there is no space, we can directly use next. So employee can have first name and last name, that's why I'm using next line. So next, enter employee role. Role equals to C dot next line. And next, enter employee salary. So salary is float. It will be like next float. Now we have successfully read the values. So we should pass these values to the query. How it will be done? P dot set int. ID will be in the first index and it is ID. And P dot set string, which is name. So name will be go to second index and it is name. P dot again set string per role. So it is in the index 3. And next p dot set float. It is in the index 4. So all are assigned to the query. So now we should execute. So int rows, affected rows will come here. And p dot execute update. Done. So this is same. Just let me copy this. So if rows greater than 0, ID, successfully inserted. Insertion. Fail. So we have completed insertion also. Now let us see how the output is looking like. Just let me run. So now we don't have any values, that's why I'm using insert first, that is add. So it is asking employee ID, I'm taking 100. So name and role come in directly because we have used so many readings now. So just let me correct it. So it is not going to next line, so just take one more. We'll see if it solves our issue. So our choice will be 2. ID 100. So let me choose to ID 100. Now name Anika, training, salary some 20,000. To successfully insert it. So we come into database and we choose select star from employees. So here name and role are not assigned, it is taking empty. Let me check that. Next line. Let us take next line here. We'll see if it solves our issue or not. Sorry, chance will be 2. And then ID. So what happened after row? So name is printing empty. One second. One second guys, and just let me check this input issue. Which is cool. let me take next line here. So now we can see we are able to print name and role also. So the issue is when we are using scanner, when we have read integer or float anything, after that when we try to read next line immediately, it won't take this next line and it is immediately printing all this. So this is the issue in with scanner. So to avoid this, we can use buffer reader, but scanner is easy, that's why we are using it for now. So just take this print when we read a next line, after that the issue resolved. So now let me comment these two and insert values. So before that, we have a empty value inside the database right here. So this we need to delete. So I will delete it from program only, as we have written the delete functionality here. So we'll use it now. So let me run this. So now we are choosing option 5. So the ID is 100. So we can see 100 successfully deleted. So if we come to database, if we see there are no result for the select star. So now we'll insert values. That is option 2. Employee ID 100. Name. So I'm using spaces also. Role training software. Salary will be 20,000. So we can see 100 successfully inserted. If we come to database, if we see select start from employees, we can see the values are inserted here. Is it clear?
Yes.
Yeah, so till now we have completed insertion, deletion, and we have completed one more thing also, that is get employee by ID also. So all three are completed. Now we'll working on update and get all employees. So all employees will be easy. Just string query select star from employees. So here we can use our statement interface also. We don't want to use statement, we can simply use prepare statement. Both are fine. I hope you remember statement interface also. So should use throws. I am passing this query using execute. So as it is select statement, we should use execute query. So execute query will be giving result set. So result set are equals to execute query. So it should print all the values so that we can use this one until result query, result set has the value. We should traverse the loop. So after every employee. We'll just print a line for the differentiation. It will give all the employees. So after that, we left with update for now. So update we'll see. Before that, we just execute all these operations and see how it is working. So I will drive first option, show employees. So it is showing employee details. We have only one employee for now, that's why showing one employee. And another option, to add the employee. So I'm taking one at one. Name, role, salary, and now one at one successfully inserted. So if you want to show all the employees, we can use one, and it is showing first employee and second employee. So if you don't want to print this employee details every time, we can simply remove this from here and keep it outside the loop. That's so we cannot get employee details every time. So after that, if you wanted to get employee by ID, so that is fourth option. I'm just leaving 100. So we can see the employee with ID 100 is here. So update didn't work. So coming to delete employee, if I'm using option 5 and I'm deleting one at one employee, and if we select all the employees, we can see after deleting only one employee is here. So if we choose any other option, it invalid choice, try again, giving same. If we choose 6, thank you for using employee management system, exiting now. So is it clear?
Yes.
Yes. So should I complete update or will you try? We left with only update. So will you try it out or I should tell now? Please respond, anyone. It's okay if you want me to tell. You will try. Okay, that's fine. So let me stop recording.